drama. I don't know if it's to work from the beginning or to now or from now to the beginning. I'll work from now because it's the smallest story. got a voicemail from the J1 physician is what I'll call it. And got the voicemail from the J1 physician. And of course, they're not disclosing. They need to talk directly to me. So it's about the status of my employment. So basically what they're telling me sounds like, without telling me, because other than my start date having moved to the 1st, the only other thing they could be telling me is that they're rescinding the offer. So, I mean, if that's the case, you know, what can I do? story in other news. As y'all know, night job, everything's great. Y'all know I absolutely adore my manager for being so laid back, for being so personable, being so cool. And he's like the best. He's the best thing ever. And as far as him knowing the job, as far as him just a people person, not being too serious, teaching me not to be so serious, you know, without actually saying it to me, but teaching me how to be more aggressive and about getting what's mine without even directly really saying it. I love my manager to death. I mean, nothing funny, but really, what a great person. Great human being. Half my age, but when I grow up, I'm gonna be like him. He is so knowledgeable about everything. Also, love the people that I work with in general. Maybe not as much as my manager, but I love them in general because, you know, they've been through some things. So they're real open and honest, you know, and I guess maybe that's why God wanted me to go through some things so that I could see that, you know, just because somebody's been through these types of things, oh my Lord, just because somebody's been through these types of things, it doesn't mean these people need skateboards, oh my gosh. Just because people have been through these types of things, they're not bad people. They are some of the most decent people that you meet. And I'll tell y'all more about this later.